Tomlinson could well prove a handful for the keeper half-back pair of Andy Ayres and King Dixon. We'll be looking for the battle there, but I have a funny feeling this is going to take place in the early exchanges in the forwards.
Yeah, I think the forwards, John, it will be all forwards in the first 10 minutes. Hopefully Keighley can dominate, which as they have done in the past, a little bit better than what they did at Doncaster last week. If they do get on top, then I think we should have a good game, give the backs some ball. Now, like I said, the two half-backs are crucial, really. Once the forwards dominate, get the ball out to the backs, get some good ball out. Here they come.
And listen to that crowd then receiving the champions-elect. Joe Grima leading his charges out. The music plays. The scene is set. Flags around the ground behind the bottom set, of course. The Keighley crowd are looking for a good performance tonight, and I feel sure that the Keighley side will also be well wound up after the somewhat disappointing display last week at Doncaster, where they eventually managed to get the 2 points. That's in the past, that's history. Tonight, hopefully, for Keighley, is history in the making. Certainly big occasions for both sides, but Darrell just remarked to my side, Darrell, about the referee.
Yeah, he's used to big occasions himself. He's refereed at Wembley. Had a good game down there. Let's hope there's another good one tonight.
And in fact, a change round, the toss having taken place. Keighley have won the toss, it looks. Joe Grimm has elected to play up the hill. And certainly Batley are looking to kick off. Stand off Lee Hanlon, the man with the honours as far as Batley are concerned. The crowd are sensing the occasion then. They're beginning to raise the voices. Mr. Smith gets the game underway as Batley kick off down to the bottom corner. Offload in there to Phil Stevenson, driving back to the 20 metre line for Keighley. Tight and early exchange between the forwards, but that's winger Andy Stephenson taking that ball in early. Jason Ramshaw spreading the ball out to Greg Harley. Greg Harley looking for Andy Ayres, unable to offload. Margaret Calvin then making the halfway as Jason Ramshaw puts the ball back down for Keith Dixon, left booted into the back of the 20 metre area. On the far touchline side, that's Paul Marshall, well met by his opposite number 5, Andy Stephenson. Batley just settling it down now and driving steadily back towards the halfway line. Mark Spencer there, took a 10 metre short. Gets it, plays the ball quickly. Jeff Gratian driving in. Certainly see Jeff Gratian driving in early, and the touch should jump from the far side of the field. Jeff Gratian looks up at Jim Smith and at the referee and says, "It wasn't me, sir." I have a funny feeling it's got to be one of the keeper players pulled out here. Joe Grima, by the look of it. Dropping with the elbow, but quite ironically there, Jeff Gratian turning to the referee saying it wasn't me, sir. Now to me, that means that he too might have been a bit guilty in his own mind,
haven't he? Yeah, I think he's holding him down there, John. It would take him off the penalty, but looking at waving his legs about and probably holding Joe down.
Well, two well-seasoned professionals there, both know the tricks of the trade. And certainly we wait to see who has the better of the exchanges. Meantime, it's Andy Parkinson getting into the Keighley 20 area. Child just having to settle 15 metres from that keeper line on through the hands of Glenn Tomlinson. 10 metres out then from the keeper line as Batley spread the ball over the far side to Gratian. Gratian tackled, but in fact referee pulling out for the penalty, and Jeff Gratian absolutely flat on his back. I'm not sure they pulled out for the penalty there, Dan, but it was the arms that blowed up off the chest as the tackle went in. Certainly Mr. Smith having a quick word with his touch judge about that. And in fact, there's a 10 minute. In fact, Joe Grima being sent off the I believe he's changed the card from yellow to red, Darrell. It looked as though it was yellow to start with, and changed it to red.
I think the main way, John, a bit hard to see behind the crowd there, but I think he'll find it off.
And Jeff Gratian's so injured he's actually walking back. He was prone on his back 2 months ago, and he's now back in the line. Joe Grima taking his place on the bench, so it may well be 10 minutes. I'm sure he brought a red card out, he certainly brought a yellow out to start with. I thought he'd change it to a red though. Well, Jim Smith referee not indicated the reason for the penalty, but certainly Dell just remarked off the mic that you can't give a sin bin for a head high. It's either tell him off or send him off. And that's missed, and Joe Grima in fact is taking his way, making his way to the dressing room, so obviously he has been sent off. And that's sending off coming only 4 minutes, less than 10 minutes into the game. Something that Keighley could well have done without, but you will recall that referee Jim Smith pulled him out just 30 seconds before that incident for, in his description, use of the elbow in the tackle on Jeff Gratian. It was a similar incident, again with that same number, that same man, that led to Joe's departure onto the bath on the bench in the dressing room. Keighley then with physically and actually an uphill climb here now. They've got 12 men for the last 76 minutes of this game. A real test of character if ever there was one. Oh, and the gap being produced there. And in fact the man dropping on the ball, the knock on having taken place. So we see a scrum down, referee Mr Smith bringing the scrums from 30 metres out. I suppose technically the scrum should have formed another 5 metres upfield, but where the knock on took place, but satisfying to say that that's where it took place. And Keighley now in possession of Stephenson, breaking up, loses the ball in the tackle, 10 metres inside his own half of the field there. It's Phil Stephenson just spilling the ball in the way to that tackle. Scrum down then as Tomlinson goes on to feed his scrum in and out to Batley. Fullback Wilson joining in the action there after Lee Hanlon manages to offload. Roy Marshall tackling on the ball across now then through the hands to Andy Parkinson on this near side of the field. Creation moving the hands across Luke Tomlinson and offload there, but that ball being kicked forward. And in fact it was a knock on. Certainly was a knock-on, was that? But I don't think the referee's actually given a knock-on. Batley's given a tap on the 20.
He already given a knock-on, John. It was play on there. He was giving that Batley kicked it dead. That's what they did. I certainly knocked out of my eyes.
Well, I thought the man put the ball down to the ground and then kicked it in desperation. Mr Smith having different interpretation on that, obviously. However, Keith will live to fight another day. 8 metres inside the Batley half. It's Greg Hiley. Almost back to the halfway line, and Dixon putting Carlton Farrell into a half hole there. Keighley venturing into the opposition territory for almost the first time as Phil Stephenson this time. It is 30 metres out from the line, but it's the fifth and last tackle as Ramshaw gets the ball across to Keith Dixon. He hoists that high, but it's going up and it's almost going to come straight down, but Grayson managing to recover the ball after it bounced Paul Batley just outside their own 20 metre line. Batley slowly to the feet then, and the crowd going hushed. Does Batley get out of that 30 metre area? Grayson once more turning inside, but can't get away from the tackling of Jason Ramshaw and Greg Harley on that occasion. The two Batley players on this side stand off, and number three Jimmy Irvine having one or two rather strong words to say to the touch judge on this side. Touchfinder going in 10 metres from the Keighley line. We've got a scrum down then. It's on the air, feeding the scrum for Keighley. Stepping right the back, and I think if anything, Gavin, the sticky conditions, the heavy conditions could well be more assistance to Batley tonight than to Keighley. They're used to playing on a grassless field, and one which is consistently heavy. But that's a nice ball out there, Carlton Farrell tackle goal.
Yes, it is, John. It's, like I say, Batley's pitch is quite a poor pitch with Batley and Jules playing on it. So he does get a fair bit of wear. But Keighley's pitch is looking in good nick today to say all the rain that we've had. Having said that, Headingley's off tonight, so just showing how much rain there has been. And the pitch is holding it well.
Stephenson then on the halfway line for Keighley, still penned inside his own half of the field. Lost Carlton Farrell waits acting half. Keith Dixon putting the ball up to the top right hand corner as we look at it, almost to the try line area. Big heavy tackle there on that Batley player, running away by Greg Hiley. Andy Ayres doing the tackling again there on the 20 metre line. Wayne Race marshalling his defence behind this line from the full back position, and Batley being driven back inside their own 20-metre line once more. Slight hint of a knock-on there from Hooker Tommy Allwright going unchecked. As Batley break down that far side, but the movement breaks down as the pass from Simon Wilson to winger Marshall goes astray. We've got 10 minutes on the clock, the score still locked at 0 as the scrum dials down, airs out, and certainly the Batley defence in the shape of stand off Lee Hamlin well in front of that 5-metre line before the ball coming out. Miller should really be able to take this the centre might have moved apart. More akin to playing in the loose forward position is Booth. But Mark Cowden putting the ball down there, allowing his opposite number Mark Cass to set up another attempt for Batley to attack the Keighley defensive area. Jeff Gration lying away from the action and standing off the centre field area. Ball distribution position is Tomlinson, dummy sideways, that looked a bit forward there to the hooker, but a brilliant tackle there by Wayne Race. There's Tomlinson and Eyres, look at Tomlinson there, throwing in the punches on Andy Eyres, and in fact it looks as though there could be a try on here, but the referee's really going to have to come back. Tomlinson was really laying into Andy Eyres in the centre of the field there, off the ball, no question about it. The touch judge is going to have to sort it out because Mr. Smith never saw it, that's for sure. Off the ball, Tomlinson should be joining, in my opinion, Dale, he should be joining in the bath with Joe Grima, surely.
Well, it's up to the touch judge, Johnny, all depends what he saw. They saw the first or the second punch, they might have seen Andy Eyres retaliating, I don't know. Just telling him now what it's, I think Wade's waving his arms about, I don't think he saw it, he's going for a card. He's getting number 7 now. Calling on the Eyres.
Well, he's calling on the Eyres up this side and he's certainly calling out their standoff as well. He's got the red card in his hand. He's fidgeting in his pocket for something else. It looks as though if the way it's going on, we're going to finish with no players on the park, Darrell.
Yeah, well, he's got to stop this stupidness early on, John. So we're getting the football.
And he's certainly took, he's sent them both off for 10 minutes, no he hasn't. He's certainly not sent Andy Eyres off, he's just telling Greg Harley to get away from the action. But he's certainly sent Tomlinson for 10 minutes, that's for sure. He's now sent Andy Eyres for 10. He's now got to decide, Alan.
Well, he's giving the try, John, he's letting play go. And yet that took place before the try. So he's sort of, what he's saying is that 6-1 half does not other. Nobody guilty, it's play on. Bad decision there, we should have made a decision. Get the penalty one way or the other.
As it is though, we've got the try for Batley on the sheet. And just look at the way that Mr. Smith's looking at the ground there and questioning what's gone on. It makes you wonder in fact whether he runs as well, he should have changed that decision for the try. The crowd don't like it, Simon Wilson's got the opportunity though, putting back with 6 in front. And that's going to the left hand side. No goal, but the try coming, I didn't see who it was who scored it. Now, in fact it was the fullback Wilson who scored and tried to convert his own try. Well, we're down to 12 for Batley and 11 for Keighley. Dixon then restarts, Batley have got the extra man, as they have had from the 4th minute of course, but the defence is going to be much more difficult for the gaps to cover now, with Keighley 2 men short. Good weight tackling there by Mike Brookyard and Jason Ramshaw on the hooker and with Tommy Allwright. Jimmy Irvine just stepping through, kicking out, trying to release himself from that tackle as Gracia gets the ball over the far side of the field. Offloading the tackle, gets the ball out via Cass and it comes over this side to Whiteside Parkinson. Just inside of 8 metres inside the back half of the field. Oh man. going back there. Culbertson to pump downfield eventually. Puts it down. Great race down there in the in-goal area. Recovers the ball. Steps round. The initial attempted tackle of Hamlin, but eventually falls to his tackle just inside his own 20. Stephenson now. Andy Stephenson breaking out to the 20 for Keighley. Carlton Farrell. A good 10 metres further forward there. Carlton Farrell getting within 10 metres of the halfway line as Ronshaw gets the ball out this turn through Dixon onto Miley. Miley are not able to afford on that occasion to Ian Gateley. It's 10 still inside the Keighley half. Plus Stephenson tackle still inside his own half of the field. It's the last tackle according to the signal given by referee Smith. The charge down coming, it's going to be back to one, is it? Yes, the referee says it's back to one. The attempt being made to take advantage as Wayne Race struggles away from the initial tackle, gets into the opposition territory as the crowd rise. Ronshaw backs the ball away there to Margaret Cowden. 10 metres inside as Jason Ramshaw goes on his own. Now that ball was stripped out, Darrell.
Yeah, he's looked at both touches there, did Jim? Neither touch just did out down here. I don't think this one down underneath has realised it had gone.
He certainly looked to be stripped out the way the ball flew backwards, but not seen by either touch judges. We have a better viewpoint from up top as Mark Katz then tackles from 10 metres inside the keeper half. Decoration then through the hands of his stand-up Hamlin. Chips over the top by Irvine. Jason Ramshaw recovers that. Mark Miller then acting half-back. Well chased by Gary Thornton, the number two for Batley. Still inside the keeper 20 as Dixon gets the ball away this time to Gateley. Gateley half bursting through the first tackle but not able to get away from it. Down there by Mark Spence as he plays the ball, but Keighley over the far side. It's Andy Stephenson this time almost to the halfway line. Carlton Farrell acting half-back gets the ball away and the ball being dropped again in the tackle. The ball obviously quite greasy there. Margaret Cowden again not necessarily up back last time, but not able to answer the ball. Just a little bit slippy there. Ball out there to Batley. Wingman Paul Marshall tackled on the halfway line. That's Michael Gould tackled some 5 metres inside the Keighley half of the field. 18 minutes of the first half gone. Somebody certainly needs to sort out the standoff because that's a good move. As well, Darrell, we said early doors, didn't we, at the standoff and the scrum half of Batley could cause Keighley some trouble. And my words, how right that seems to be.
Yeah, you're right there, John. It all comes from Keighley knocking the ball on, though. But the course standoff down, it's creating move. He did a little bit of shepherding in the middle there. Jim let it go. He stood back. He offloaded out to the wing and then backed him back up. Inside pass, 4 points.
Yeah, 4 points in as the standoff gets that try, Lee Hanlon. Better this time though, certainly is. 10 points to nil then, Batley lead almost halfway through the first half.
Yeah.
just inside outside his own try line, gets back to the 20 before being tackled, and 2 or 3 metres further forward by the second man in the defensive run out of the area. Andy Parkinson, 30 metres then from the battle line, gets up, plays the ball through the hands of Hooker and a whole right. Playing the ball and looks like it might be the Hooker home right there, getting almost to the halfway line. And here comes the kick again, through, looking for the touchline finder. Just managing to go in 10 metres from touch. And Keighley driven back down this slope once more. Struggle form on that 10 metre mark, some 10 metres from the try line. Andy Ayres having a bar at McKeith Dixon. Andy Ayres, of course, in the sin bin to feed the scrum. But Batley's certainly got the strength in the weight to push Keighley off the ball, had the so wished. Not able to do so on that occasion. Miller acting half back onto Dixon. Dixon just shimmying left and right. Ramshaw then onto Gateley. Gateley driving in up this Keighley slope. 10 metres from the halfway line. Going to get a penalty there though for the second push down. The tackle had been made and the second push down deemed by Mr. Smith to be holding down and not allowing the Keighley number 11, Ian Gateley, to get the ball. Number 12. Penalty then going into touch some 8 metres inside the Batley half. Ian Gateley running the ball towards the 30 metre line. Carlton Farrell taking the ball in. Past the shade level, probably forward, but Mr. Smith allowing it to go as Dixon now for... Oh, and a good juggling out there. Thought that ball had been put down. In fact, it's been lost and regathered by Batley. And Keighley caught offside at this side, but I think perhaps Mr. Smith could also have caught Keighley for moving off the mark there and not standing square before the ball being played. Chose to take the offside option right in the centre of the field. And Batley opted to run this ball and not to kick for touch. Decoration doing well to hang on to that ball as he's tackling and trying to turn. A penalty. I was just looking at the defensive line there. Referee Jim Smith said it was the punching on the intervention of touches. Dan, did you actually see anything?
Oh, punching, I saw a little bit high, but certainly no punching.
Intervention of the touch, judge was previously missed something. Probably went on the influence of the crowd in the scattered shed below us. Quickly then, Nation. Driving through Andy Ayres, the two men in the sin bin, Andy Ayres and Tomlinson now back on the field, one for each side. And Keighley go inside their own 20 metre area. Defending here as the ball moves across to the far side of the field, into the hands of Michael Hoover, just tackled off on the Keighley 20. As Batley now look forward, Tom. Through onto Mark Spencer. As Tomlinson puts the ball high for the chase, he's after it. Wayne Race, the man taking it with ease, and Tomlinson there rattling round Wayne Race as he tackles him. Mark Miller then tackled and plays the ball. It's Stephenson running away towards the 20 metre line. Almost having his eyes pulled out there by Hanlon as he was tackled in the third man. Andy Ayres now as Stephenson, Phil Stephenson this time, breaks out of the 20 but loses the ball. Jeff Gratian drops on it. The ball not secure there. played, and now Keighley got the job of defending once more as the ball goes out to the far side, kicked through again, and got into touch. Well marshalled into touch there by Keighley. They'll be going down still now. And the substitution being made by Keighley, Margaret Cowden leaving the field. It looks like Steve Hall will be seen coming on. I think Darrell probably just won that a forward light. The coach going to try and spread the workload out amongst the forwards.
Probably so, John. Yeah, like we said in the past, it's hard these forwards. Certainly when they run down, spread the workload around it. Mark has made one or two mistakes. He dropped the ball a couple of times. They might just want him off to calm him down, give him a breather.
Yeah, maybe so. And a good early run through there by Steve Hall, taking the player towards the halfway line. Carlton Farrell certainly receiving some treatment round the head. Ian Gateley gets the ball out to this wing side as John Basilou ducking inside. Mark Milner taking the ball through, on through the hands of Andy Ayres, Jason Ramshaw, Keith Dixon switching play back with Phil Stevenson. The last tackle comes up once more then as Mr. Smith raises his arms in the air as Ramshaw gets the ball across then as Dixon chips over the top and chases. And the tackle made just onside. The man obviously either behind Keith Dixon or Keith Dixon put him onside. And Keighley really do need to keep the pressure on this Batley defence now. We've had 26 minutes in the first half. Batley then driving out the form there of Mark Spencer, the number 12, still inside his own 20 metre area. Grayson as he tries to go back in field. That's five tackles consumed and something like 15 metres territorial advantage gain. The ball going through the hands of Tomlinson there, very fortunately for Batley, being received by one of his colleagues as Wayne Race gathers the kick through, gets back to the halfway line before being tackled, gets it quickly, plays the ball. That man certainly offside, not even standing square, but Keith Dixon offloading there is his tackle back there to Stevie Hall, but he's not going to be able to offload. The referee calls the tackle held. Jason Ramshaw just dummies there off to Andy Ayres, but tackling 10 metres inside the back of the half of the field. 10 points to nil, Keith the trail at the moment. Oh, and Gateley taken out off the ball there, Mr. Smith, and really now then that's got to be 2 points. But really, you know, I mean, a deliberate foul like that's a 10-minute sin bin, Darrell. That's professional, isn't it?
Yeah, but John, the only thing we get him inside the 20, as I said in the past, outside the 20 when he kicked it. So, no sin bin.
And the penalty obviously being given in that case from the point where the ball stopped and be picked up by a Batley player, because if it's inside the 20, my goodness me, you don't get much closer to the 20 than that. John Basilou, though, now looking to get Keighley on the board and reduce the arrears. Certainly the deliberate shoulder charge there, not foul play, but certainly professionally foul play, prevented that run through by Ian Gateley to play his own chair. The touch judges agree. Keighley on the way. They've got 2 points back. Almost half an hour of the first half gone. Keighley trailing now by 10-2 thanks to that John Basilou goal. Coming back and His shoulder charge, Barge. Tomlinson's in again with the elbows round the head. The referee taking notice, no notice, and really Mr. Tomlinson's going to have to be careful, Dadley. He's spent 10 minutes in the bin. If he does anything again, he's off, isn't he?
We hope so, Jim.
He's certainly causing a bit of hassle and aggravation with the elbow there in the tackle on Steve Hall. As Ian Gaffey now takes the ball in. 10 metres inside the back of the half of the field, gets up and plays the ball to Ramshaw, on through Ayres, run round with Ayres and Dixon, Ayres through the gap, Keith Dixon's going, Keith Dixon's still going, but the ball goes behind Ramshaw, but John Vassalou's on hand to regather. The last tackle coming up, the ball could spread to the right, there's plenty of players in cover, and Ayres on to Ian Gateley, Gateley's in by the post. Oh, what a good try that was. Batley had no idea what had happened there. They were expecting the ball going out wide, Dowell, and Greg Hiley pushed the ball back into Gateley for a well thought out try. And who said forwards can't think?
Yeah, we well planned with that, John. The last tackle, the two options are key. They throw it out wide or keep. They took neither. They drove, passed back inside, like you said, Ian Gateley inside of the post. Excellent try.
Certainly was, and probably one of the best we've seen down here so far this season. The season's almost over. Straight through the middle. So we've got 7 minutes left of this first half of the 40 allocated, plus any stoppage time, as Stevie Hall now drives the wall back up towards the 20. And that will certainly have given Keith a considerable amount of heart, and it will not have pleased the Batley players to have conceded a try, but the offload there by Phil Stevenson certainly won't have pleased the Keighley coaches either, so close to his own line. Having conceded possession, we've now got Batley back on the wrong page down the slope. Number 11, Darren Child, just steadying things down for Batley as the hooker now takes the ball in. Dips in the tackle, does Tommy Allwright, takes play inside the Keighley 20. As the ball spins across, Gratian turning inside for Tomlinson. He switches play back again to Andy Parkinson, but he's left stranded. The Batley support not helping him at all as Jim Smith raises the arm for the last tackle. Tomlinson kicks to the far touchline. Oh, and the ball missed there by Keighley and by the Batley defender, the Batley and Monson player. Going into touch, ball beating both defender and attacker there. The vagaries of the rugby league ball obviously having a big effect on the decisions of the players, or the commitment to the two players there. Batley certainly pushing very hard against this Keighley pack as the ball goes in, out this time to the satisfaction of Mr. Smith. To win race, to win race, and able to get beyond the 20 metre line. Stevie Hall again receiving treatment, this time Jimmy Irvine, the man giving it out. Andy Ayres then across to Dixon, Dixon chipping through, kicks again, chases, the wingman tackled in possession, Gary Thornton, the knock on there, certainly missing by the referee and the touch should the referee in the shade of the player's body, not able to see it, but certainly the touches on this side should have given him some assistance. It was only the smallest of knock-ons, but it was there. 10 metres inside the Batley half then as Hanlon gets the ball out to this side. Mark Miller does the tackling. Appealing to the tricksters for Jimmy Irvine. Probably some aggravation in the tackle as Mr. Smith once more raises his arm for the last tackle. Man at the far side is offside. He isn't now though because it's all on Stephenson playing the ball, but certainly Michael Gould was in an offside position when the ball was kicked. Carlton Farrell stepping out of that tackle on there to Wayne Race. Well, I was going to say going to have to be satisfied with going down there, but still managed to get another couple of yards. But Ian Gateley now bursting into Batley territory. On there to Keith Dixon gets 10 metres inside the Batley half of the field. Up appears the ball to Jason Ramshaw. Andy Ayres offering the ball and then switches to Mark Milner. Milner though going to be tackled on the 20 metre line. And in fact, a knock-on being noticed there by the referee. We've got 4 minutes left on the clock to half-time. This scrum then going down, 10 metres in front touch, up the 20 metre line for Batley. Tomlinson feeds the ball, gets it out to himself, round the back. Hanlon there just caught in possession with looking for the support, there was one available as Thornton now takes the ball across the air. Stepping back inside there, number 12, Spence at all back there, 12 metres from the halfway line, inside the back of the half of the field. Looking to move across there, but perhaps should have done better had he offloaded there, Michael Bull. As it was, he decided to hang on it. Hang on to it, keeping him down there from that tackle. Greg Harley prone on the field as Tomlinson puts the ball and it goes into touch just outside the 20 metre area. The referee, Mr. Smith, stops the clock. Causing a bit of concern for the FIFA physio. And Gateley just taking the precaution measure on the far touch there side of warming up substitute Charlie McAllister. Fortunately, goalkeeper Greg Harley gets back to his feet again. Certainly had a big game in this first half, being instrumental in the formation on the production of that try for Keighley. Still takes his place back at the open side, Brock, the ball coming out to Keighley, and John Vassalou almost overrunning that ball as he came round the back of the pack, having to check it as he went through. And Dixon now onto Stevie Hall. Steve Hall taking on the Batley forwards. And Jason Ramshaw through there, Neil Gateley bursting up to the halfway line. 10-8 the scoreline in Batley's favour at the moment. Ayres through to Dixon. Mark Milner gets, the crowd thought it was pretty bad. The referee on the point of giving a penalty for holding down there and thought better of it as Ramshaw kicks that ball up. That's a tester for the chase. Fullback Wilson takes the ball over his own try line as the Keighley defence gets back up there. Tackle 5 metres from the try line. And in fact, well, a little bit harsh possibly there. He's been allowing the lane on to go quite regularly, but he seems to have just pan down a little bit tight there, Dale. Probably tighter than he's been so far.
Yeah, in a lot of ways, John. They wanted it by all. Give all the defence to get back. But, normally they let it go there. A bit harsh, really hard.
Understand the lane on penalising when the attacking side's inside the opposition's 20, but when you're looking there for it, milking it, I would have thought referees would have been a bit beyond being conned into a milking penalty. However, Batley now coming down 7 or 8 metres inside their own half of the field. Gracious stepping through the mud, offloads there in the centre of the field, out there to the wing of Thornton. But John Vassalou manages to halt his forward motion momentum there as Matt Miller steps around this time. To do the tackling this time on the hook of Holloway. Inside through the runs of Tomlinson and Hanlon. Misses out the centre and a lot of sweeping up to be done there by Michael Booth. He shouldn't really have got that ball in that position. A And there goes Jimmy Irvine, kicking that ball left foot downfield, green race. Ooh, we're doing a little bit of a juggling up there as Irvine half tackles him, but Tomlinson, with the assistance of Mark Cass, finishes him off 15 metres from his own line. Stevenson once more getting outside his own 20 metre area. An ironic chase from the crowd there as Jim Smith this time catches Batley offside, and I think Gadley's been a bit lenient with this offside because certainly Keighley have been creeping up on the fringes, haven't they, as well?
Yeah, both sides have, Jim. I think it's taken them a good 10 to 12, and as the ball's been a bit played, they're walking forward, letting it go.
It certainly produces good open rugby, there's that, allowing it to flow, but I suppose rules are rules as Jason Ramshaw then steps inside. Almost a suggestion of shepherding there. This is Carlton Farrell though, stepping through the centre. 22 metres out from that Batley line as Ramshaw gets the ball from the play of the ball. Eyres chips over the top for the chase, putting that wingman under pressure on the far side, doing the tackling himself. We've got 41 minutes on the clock already, nearly a minute and a half in fact, into stoppage time this half. 10 points to 8, keep the trail. I think Gallen will be quite happy to go in now with that scoreline, having gone 10-0 back behind at one stage.
I think they will, John. They've come back well. I think just now Batley out now, or maybe even pinched it themselves before half-time. All to the good.
But it's going to be difficult to pinch it whilst they haven't got possession, but Mr. Smith's got his arm in the air. It's blasting once more as the ball's punted deep down into Keighley territory. Great race, using his feet, bending his back, picking the ball up. Running across the face of play and getting away, but caught by the shirt collar there by Hanlon. The standoff for Batley. Put to ground as Mark Milner now stepping through the centre of the field. Looking for a hole in that Batley defence, but not able to find it. There's very, very few holes appearing in the midfield defence area. As Steve Hall, using his considerable size and strength to try and get away, not being allowed to get away though. And again, certainly a suspicion of holding there as the ball being given out. Andy Ayres giving the ball out, suspect Tomlinson must have called for it. And Batley now moving the ball across to this short side, on this close side as far as we're concerned. Two tackles gone. 10 metres inside their own half of the field. Glacier now just driving the ball in. Satisfied to take the tackle. Oh, and a big hit there on the number 12. Mark Spencer, the ball spills in the tackle as Steve Hall gets the ball but unable to make any serious headway into the Batley half. Jason Ramshaw acting half onto Phil Stevenson. Well met there though by the Batley defence. Eyley, he's no be outside him, that's where the man's missing on that far side at the moment with the absence of Joe Grima. Jason Ramshaw plays that, gets that ball, and Andy Ayres steps through again, getting through the half break every time, but just not able to make the full break at the moment as Dixon gets the ball out to the right hand side. Ramshaw tackled there or barged off the ball as he went, as he kicked it through. Gets up on his feet though, and that ball having to be kicked dead by Batley. Taking all the time in the world to bring the ball back to the centre. Thought perhaps Mr. Smith might have stopped the clock here as well, Dally.
Yeah, they could do it, John. They're not exactly rushing with the ball, are they? They don't want to get back. They've got the advantage with the hill. I think they want to get play on.
Well then, brought back into play. We've now had 4 minutes of stoppage time in this first half as Steve Hall takes the ball back in. 30 metres out, but there goes the half-time hooter. We've got a half-time score of 10 points to 8 in the favour of Batley at the moment. Their tries game from the full-back Simon Wilson. And Lee Hanlon stand-off will come back. Keighley retake the field after the half-time break. They've had a change of shirts, Darrell, and it had to be done, didn't it? Because obviously the way in which the players were picking up the mud in the latter half of this first half, it would be very difficult to even identify one from the other, wouldn't it?
It certainly would, John, and now Keighley hopefully will see each other a bit better. As you say, Batley haven't changed. They can't make out the colour of the shirts, it all looks black. Good move by Keighley, this.
Also makes the players feel that little bit better as well, coming out with a clean top. Minutes left then, Keighley trailing by those 2 points, down of course to those 12 men as well, as Mr. Smith gets the game back underway. Keith Dixon puts the boot to ball down deep into the Batley territory, and Keith will be looking to keep them penned in this half of the field, or certainly towards the bottom half of the field, before this saves the 6 tacklers. 2 gone then. Meters out then from the back line, the tackles have been consumed as Keighley keep the Batley players, the Batley defence, or attack rather, under pressure. 4 tackles used. Mr. Smith still not raised his arm as the ball moves over the far side. Tomlinson kicks, and it was touched by a Keighley player on the way through. Mr. Smith waves it back to one. Just inside that 10-metre line, Batley now coming forward, getting away from the first tackle. Bring on Gary Thornton. First 10 minutes of the second half, Darrell, very, very testing time, isn't it?
Certainly is. John Keighley's going to have the wits about them. They're going to come out of this second half wide awake and really capitalising, closing Batley down all the time, keeping the game in the Batley half as much as they can.
Meantime, Batley inside that Keighley half of the field, having had the advantage of the count back as the kick was just touched by a Keighley player, and 2 men involved in that tackle could create a gap for the Batley attack in the centre of the field, which was almost exploited there. But this is the last tackle. Hanlon gets up and plays the ball onto Tomlinson. Tomlinson chips over the top. Wayne Race is there to take the ball. Tomlinson on hand to attempt to do the tackling, but Wayne Race gets back to that 20-metre line. And the rain really coming down hard here now in this second half. Good breakout of defence there by Wayne Race. Phil Stevenson just consolidating the move forward. Stevie Hall draws the breath as he gets into the opposition territory. Trying to get up and play the ball, eventually gets up and plays it. Andy Ayres now misses out Keith Dixon, runs round with Ian Gateley over the top there, but that ball forward, but it's not been a call forward as John Vassalou picks the ball up, tackled inside the 10-metre line. Looked as though it might have been forward, but Mr. Smith said not. And this is Gateley now on the ascendancy, looking for the offload in front of those posts belonging to Batley. It's the last tackle now. Jason Ramshaw puts the ball out there. Stevenson has to do the juggling, but Andy Stevenson's in. Is he? Yes, the referee's given the try. Andy Stevenson finishing off in the corner. And that was real persistence, wasn't it, Darrell? Because the Batley defence had moved across very, very quickly. And yet, Phil Stevenson juggled with the ball, got it out quickly to brother Andy, and he finished off.
Excellent try that, John. It just shows what he can do. Last tackle again, you see. Shows that back Keighley willing to throw the ball about in the last tackle. Football, that's what it's all about.
Just manages to edge Keighley those 2 points in the lead then. Conversion attempt, but regardless of any hassle or whatever he gets from the crowd, I think Scottish footballers certainly won't take any effect on his preparation. But nonetheless, that's taken Keighley into the lead. And the crowd need to get behind this Keighley side now to keep them going. And they certainly are doing just that. Put up the field into the hands of Dixon. Brings on Stephenson, the try scorer. The wingman taking that ball infield as he's done for the most of this season. Driving that ball out from the kickoff. Big fella Steve Hall bursting the tackle again. Almost gets back to the halfway line before Mark Cass doing the tackling for Batley. Greg Hiley leading the charge again as Keighley get into that back of the half of the field. Jason Ramshaw through the hands of Eyres, runs around with Dixon. Keith Dixon, but Andy Eyres stepping through the centre. Keith Dixon unable to get back to him because he was tackled after he left. Got rid of that ball, but it's Dixon back on station again as Stephenson this time. Phil Stephenson, that is, 15 metres out, protects the ball as the referee calls held, and Keith Dixon just chips that ball through into the try area. A little knock on there. The referee seeing the knock on over the try line. It's a drop out from underneath the battle post. And certainly a very, very good kick through there by Keith Dixon, causing no end of problems to the Batley defence double.
Well, excellent kick that, John. It had them all back pedalling there. When a one man and need to turn out to take it. Good knocked on. Good move.
Keith Dixon, the man, regaining the ball now. Stepping back inside, going into the centre of the field, 20 metres out. Brings on Phil Stephenson, the big forward, driving that ball into those battle defenders. 15 metres out as Ramshaw plays the ball onto the big fella Gateley. Looking for the offload, but there was nobody to offload to. He was running towards the support to the wing, but it's Jason Ramshaw now feeding Greg Hiley, but Greg Hiley not able to turn that ball. Just when caught it on the shoulder, not the best of passes, but certainly was a defensively splitting pass had it come off. Inside that Batley 10 metre line now as Keighley driving the Batley defenders back all the time. The rain pouring down here at Keighley. Number 12 there, Mark Spencer, the Batley numbers. The Batley numbers disappearing in the mud, but Batley have got the numbers here. Unfortunately, didn't manage to offload the first time there, didn't move. Oh, and a knock on there. Knock on there by Mark Cass. And it was on the last tackle, so it's a handover now then to Keighley, just inside their own half of the field. Good yards made there by Phil Stephenson, five inside the Batley half as Ramshaw gets the ball off to Eyres. Eyres puts Greg Hiley in the gap, but just pulled back by his shirt tail. Eyres again, stepping as he goes, evading the first tackle, but again, just not able to get that extra half yard clear of the defence so he could either offload or go through the gap. Gator switching the ball back inside there. Greg Hiley now taking the play inside the Batley 10. Ramshaw to acting half back. The play's on over here. Oh, that was not the best of drop goal attempts there by Andy Eyres. Gator did have a decent line out this side, but really me. What an absolute mess Jimmy Holroyd made of that, Darley. He got six tackles to drive away from his own 20 and he knocks on.
Ooh, somebody hope you're happy about that, John. Keighley will load, they should get the ball back out of this one. Keep the pressure on like they're doing. Keep this pressure going, there should be some more points in this game from you.
Certainly should, and David Ward, as you say, the Batley captain, will not be pleased. And he's just doing the first one as he came through, looking to take on the Batley defence, but Batley shutting him down as Mark Milner now attempts to stride through this defence. Big fella Steve Hall there, setting things up, 5 metres from that Batley line as Ramshaw waits, acting half back, switches for the running forward. there for a ram shot, tries to do the ferry, but Burrow underneath, but no way through from there. Ball should have, well, it wasn't exactly the best of play that was there, giving Batley back the advantage. Keighley now going to get back on that defensive line and keep Batley pinned down there. Certainly some full weight tackling going in there, Della, by this Keighley defence at the moment, isn't there?
Yeah, Batley are filling every one of these tackles now, John. They're having trouble getting outside their own 10, let alone their own 20. This is what Keighley got to do. They've got to try and keep them down here. The longer Batley's down here, the more likely they are making mistakes.
There goes the veteran Gratian driving out. Good drive out there by the veteran player. 25 metres out, he finished up going down. Now spread the ball across the field, and it's a nice ball, well taken. The numbers inside and outside, but Paul Marshall, well tackled there by the Keighley defenders of Carlton Farrell and Phil Stevenson. But Batley now coming back up, Tomlinson switches that ball inside to Cass, and the ball lost. Ian Gateley regathering for Keighley. Certainly shouldn't count as the first tackle as Wayne Race goes. That should be the first tackle. Count now. The advantage line not having been made in the first instance. Oh, but that ball thrown away. But fortunately, Keith Dixon doing the sweeping behind. That should be two. Greg Hiley now taking play into the opposition half of the field. The referee, we just heard there, call three. Not counting that first tackle where the advantage was not made. And Andy Ayres losing that ball as he was tackling. Obviously it's becoming like a lump of soap out there as the ground gets heavier with this persistent rain down.
Yeah, John, I think that's why Keith's got to keep him down here. But he could struggle to get the full length, and yeah, looked like he nearly did then. Good tackle there. But they're struggling to get the full length. If Keith didn't keep it down at this bottom end of the park, they're with a good chance.
Hanlon though getting that ball out from being under pressure. The wingman running across the field, Gary Thornton, and certainly Paul Marshall, his opposite wing partner, has been having some telling breaks up this near side. Batley then 10 metres from the Keighley line, they're doing the pressures. Tomlinson switches that ball, and the ball put down there, and that's going to be a knock on. We'll be seeing a scrum from 15 metres or so out from the Keighley line. It'd be Keighley's head and feet. And just put a ton of players looking for some shots. Ian Gateley just having his changed. And Harley, beg your pardon. Ian Gateley just receiving a bit of treatment. Lost the ball in the tackle, Batley regathered. Batley now setting up their tack here as the standoff Hanlon runs across the face of play, gets away from the first tackler, but throws that ball anywhere and it comes to a Batley player in the shape of Darren Child. Ball lost in the tackle there, referee allowing play to go on. Big gaps there on the try line area in the Keighley defence as Batley get the ball across. Hanlon throwing the ball away, really wasted an opportunity there, but Darrell, that was another bad mistake by referee Mr Smith, wasn't it? There's no doubt that ball was lost in the tackle over the far side.
Yeah, the tackle was completed, I thought, John, and the ball came out and let play go. I mean, it went back fair enough, but Woods have made the tackle, the committee. So I can't understand why they give a scrum, you know, if they lost it in the tackle, no penalty.
Well, another substitution taking place for Keighley. Mark Brookcown and recovers the field, and Andy Stephenson takes a well-deserved rest. And the Batley player there caught offside, stand-off Hanlon encroaching on the 5-metre area behind the scrum. Indicated by the referee, by the touches at the far side to referee Smith. And a good touch finder there, 10 metres in the Keighley half of the field. Keighley just that slender 2 points in the lead at the moment as Jay Craig Harley burst through there, but brought down just inside the opposition's territory. Matt Buchanan driving the ball in, nearly 10 metres inside the battle half of the field. Ball now going across there, through the hands of Eyres. Eyres looking for the man coming through, but it moves slightly, breaking down in centre field possibly there, as Eyres was spotted by the Batley defence. They're still going the same way there, onto Ian Gateley, the big second rower taking play onto the Batley 20. But it's the last one coming up. Mr. Smith has his arm in the air as Gateley plays the ball. Ball high in the air for the chase and the under. The man taking the ball there, in fact, is Keith, and it's a try! Oh, what a good kick there that was! Keith Dixon placed a perfect kick in the air. He followed it up. It looks as though it might have been Steve Hall, was it, who scored. Steve Hall behind the man who kicked the ball, took the ball over. Defender and all, right at the side of the post. That's 4 points further on the board for Keith Liddell. What a pressure ball that was.
Beautiful kick there. Keith followed it all up, put everybody onside, put the man taking the ball under pressure. Up came Steve Hall, putting him under more pressure, took the ball, and over that by the side of the post. Beautiful try.
Well, it certainly was, and well appreciated by the crowd. John Basilou now. He's got the task of converting this. We've got 16 minutes gone in the second half. Batley have got a long way to come back up this hill as John Basilou successfully converts that. Puts Keighley 8 points clear now. So then Keighley take the lead now, 18 points to 10. There's Hanlon, Harris to restart, every one of his players in front of him there before he actually kicked that ball, but as we said so often, referees this season not really interested enough offside at play the ball. Every team does it at the kick-off, I beg your pardon. Every team does it and gets away with it. Keighley now coming down as Ian Gateley turns in the tackle there, taking the ball back to the defender there. The forward Jeff Grayson in an offside position, not making an attempt to get back as Mark Brook-Cowden gets almost to the halfway line, gets up, plays the ball. Jason Ramshaw puts it back to the left boot of Dixon. He searches for the touchline and finds it. 10 metres out from that Batley line, driving Batley all the way down the slope, Dell, and they know the Batley above any other club in this league how hard it is when you drive the opposition down the slope for them to come back up it.
Yeah, certainly do, John. It was a good toss for Keighley to win today. Getting the slope in the second half, conditions have deteriorated. Batley's got all this mountain to climb. They're 8 points down and up this hill. Hard for anybody.
Referee Mr. Smith just not satisfied with that scrum formation. He's taking them back onto the tank. And the fed there, referee by Tomlinson, coming back out to his side. 4 metres from the 20 metre line is Batley now. Locked, desperate to get out of it, streaming away from that initial attempted tackle, but only to move sideways towards the touchline before eventually being brought down to mud. On the ball being spilled there as Keighley regather, stepping back inside, securing the position away from the touchline side. On the far side of the field, difficult to see who's in possession at the moment. Stevie Hall, who would say any other for the big fella to be involved in the centre? Jason Ramshaw, that going from his own, I believe, from acting half. Slowly to his feet, plays the ball as the ball comes out there. And certainly a move very quick off the line there by Simon Wilson. Driving Keighley back a bit, but nonetheless giving them a little bit of extra width in which to move as Gateley goes through, taking a bit high there, but not high enough to invoke the wrath of Mr. Smith. Last tackle coming up once more, Jason Ramshaw acting half. He's looked to dive through on his own, but it's the last one. 10 metres out, or less than 5 metres out from the Batley line, as Ian Gateley moves away from the marker position to do the tackling there. And it's left to the big fella Gratian to drive that ball clear and get back to the 10 metres. Batley seem content to keep this ball tight in the forwards and not spread the ball. Surely they must be aware of the situation, that they've got an extra man on the park. But Dallow,
the extra man's not really counted now, John. The only real thing that they have got another forward on, but the extra man really, you're not making much headway with it, because they can't throw the ball out where the extra man, the gaps really are out wide. They've had mud and the wet and the rain, terrible conditions. Excellent game under the conditions.
John Vazalow there though, doing well to control that ball under those slippy, wet and muddy conditions. Eventually tackled and eventually allowed to get up and play the ball. Mr. Smith being very tolerant, as I said, again on this holding down. He'll have a clamp down again, I'm sure, in a moment or two. One way or the other. Steve Hall this time tries it. Number 11, Darren Child, doing the tackling. To Greg Harley, but it's a forward pass, says Mr. Smith. Jim Smith on station there, saw that forward pass. So we've got a scrum down forming on that 10 metre line belonging to Batley. Just a slight halt at the moment while the physio comes on to attend to what was going to come on, attend to Batley play, but has second thoughts of it as the ball comes out to Batley round the back there of the scrum. And just not able to get there. It's got to be a dropout from under the post, that, but my words, pressure again there. That stand up, he doesn't like pressure, Donald, does he?
He doesn't, John, he doesn't like Keane Steve all right around his levels.
Sure, I wouldn't feel like that either, to be honest with you. Not a fellow of his size coming down on me like an express train. That's a good kick out there by Batley. Well controlled by the boot of Jason Ramshawsey. Skids through the heavy centre of the field. Greg Harley taking on the opposition, taking play to that 10 metre line. Batley defence sizing him up as it goes. Eyres switches the ball to Gateley. Gateley driving in, setting something up again for Keighley here as Ramshaw gets quickly there. Long ball out there, Carlton Farrell's in! Oh yes! Oh yes! Oh, and that's a good try there!
Come on, Gates! Settle them down! Joe, there, the three sisters. You get a wonderful meal. And the sponsor today is a big welcome to Joe and the Three Sisters Hotel.
Well,
Oh,
and the long tackle completely off his feet there. An absolute clothesline tackle, nothing short of a clothesline. Gets away with it, we'll say, go away and behave yourself, young fellow. Hardly surprising, the crowd really get upset at these high tackles.
Coming up, fellas.
So then it's Keighley, this is where Jason Gordon coming out, made it back to Gates, and Steve Hall come right down the play block. Jason Ramshaw now,
here he comes,
Gateley, and Steve Hall looking to get
the two players
to support him. Gateley there, but now to Ramshaw, the ball being spilled.
Now the left of the three side, that's there.
Working right to the 10, then it's Keighley. Keeping down at his towards the centimetre line, as Bargett gets that ball away. Eventually the ball slips to the side by Jimmy Irvine. And the player being driven back and carried back. Certainly being carried all the way back there, and eventually allowed to clear that ball. That ball just coming through. Wayne Race decides that safety is the better form of defence on that occasion. Just puts the ball safely into the crowd.
Stop bridge there, wonderful pub, get an airfield pint after the match, super time. Batley coming, Andy Farrell. We've announced the man of the match in 2 seconds.
Just inside the
key. We didn't announce it now, actually. But here, Spencer, man of the match tonight is not one man of the match. He's going to name two men of the match, and he's going to pay for them both. And he names number one, Steve Hall. And number two he names is Ian Gateley.
Just inside the people 20 metre area, Steve Hall and Ian Gateley
jointly named as man of the match.
Carlton
Farrell doing a good protection job on that loose ball there. And
Stephenson
yet again drives away from that defensive area.
We can't forget our main man of the match, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen. Without them, we wouldn't be here today. Magnet Trade, don't forget them. Support them all the time. Buy your kitchen. Oh!
Jim, no car, no nothing, straight pointing. Good decision of Jim, he's got to get him away from there fast. Down this place now.
Well, the man certainly walking, certainly with two players just stepping in, Carlton Farrell. Just being pulled out by the referee.
And we're all having a good time.
I think he's just...
Don't forget Magnet Supply stretches as well.
Remaining, Keighley in the lead, 30 points to 10. The leading world championship player won the league final tonight to secure the championship. They've got that, no doubt about it now. No way back for Batley at this stage. So what a tremendous performance this has been by the entire Cougar side tonight. They've rung the changes, they've confused the Batley defence, they've moved the ball about and switched play. There's certainly above all, Darrell, one thing for sure is they've really stuck to the task tonight and the game plan.
Tell me how, Joe, whatever the people need to talk in the change room before the game at half time, you look like you stuck to it, stuck to it.
When the game is finished, very important, because the presentation will be taking place in the centre of the pitch.
Consider it a challenge.